Hi, welcome to this video. I am Niels Hagort and I work for the Cloud Platform Business Unit at VMware. In this video, I'm excited to talk to you about a new capability that we are introducing within DRS in vSphere 7 called Scalable Shares. Looking at resource pools and workloads and share entitlements, what we noticed in versions prior to vSphere 7 is that there was no dynamic relative resource entitlement between resource pools or workloads. So in this diagram, you'll see an example of what happened with resource allocations when using resource pools prior to vSphere 7. So in this instance, in this example, we have resource pool 1 set to a CPU share level of normal, and we have resource pool 2 set to a CPU share level of high. Now, we see only one virtual machine running in resource pool 1, and that'll get the full entitlement of that resource pool 1, which is 10 gig of the root resource pool that is 30 gig in this example. We have resource pool 2 set to a CPU share level of high, and two virtual machines running inside that resource pool. The resource allocation for resource pool 2 will get evenly divided between the two virtual machines running inside resource pool 2, meaning that they will also get 10 gigs of the resource pool pie. In this example, you'll notice that regardless of the resource pool CPU share level, all the virtual machines get the same resource entitlement. So there's a sibling rivalry going on, and setting a workload or a resource pool to a higher share level does not necessarily guarantee a higher resource entitlement. In vSphere 7 and DRS with scalable shares, we are solving this problem. So this is the same situation, same example, but notice that the CPU shares set to normal in resource pool 1 now only get 6 gigs entitled to it. And the virtual machines running in the resource pool set to a CPU share level of high will get 12 gigs instead of that 10 gigs. So now whenever you set a resource pool or a workload to a share level of high, we will guarantee that it will get a higher resource entitlement. This is dynamic. So whenever more virtual machine, more workloads are spun up in a resource pool, we will recalculate the resource entitlement for all the workloads running inside those resource pools. Let's have a look at how what this looks like in the UI. So it is important to understand that resource or scalable shares are not enabled by default in vSphere 7. And we have multiple options to enable them. The first and most important one is using the DRS settings on a cluster level. So whenever you configure DRS, you'll have the tab Additional Options. And in Additional Options, you can enable scalable shares. Now, whenever this is enabled, all the constructs in the cluster are using scalable shares. But maybe you don't want to set this option enabled on a cluster level, but on a resource pool level. And we can do so as well. So for example, creating a new resource pool with a high priority, four high priority workloads, and all the constructs running inside this resource pool. So that could be sibling resource pools or workloads will now use scalable shares. It is important to understand that you could use either option. So enable scalable shares on a cluster level and all the constructs on that cluster are using scalable shares, or specifically for a resource pool like we just showed. For more information on everything vSphere 7 and DRS, please have a look at the following URL. Thank you for watching.